In this video, we're going to review properties of exponents and radicals. We're going to start out with the exponent properties. One basic property is the product rule. If you have a base x to the m power times the same base x to the n power, your result is x to the m plus n. You add the exponents. Here's an example on the right. X to the fifth times x to the seventh. It's the same base, so we can add the exponents, x to the 5 plus 7, or x to the 12th. We have another property that's called the quotient rule for exponents. When we have x to the m divided by x to the n, we subtract exponents, and we get x to the m minus n. Here's an example. X to the 14th divided by x. You have to realize that x is x to the first, so we have x to the 14th divided by x to the first, we subtract exponents, we get x to the 14 minus 1, or x to the 13th. Now there's the power rule for exponents. X to the m raised to the n power is x to the m times n. Here's an example. If we have the fifth power of x raised to the seventh power, we multiply the two exponents and we get x to the 5 times 7, or x to the 35th power. The negative exponent rule basically implies to invert and use the opposite power. If we have x to the negative n, we get 1 over x to the positive n. Likewise, if we have 1 over x to the negative n, the result is x to the positive n. Here's an example. 10 to the negative 2 power is 1 over 10 to the positive 2. We invert and use the opposite power. And this equals 1 100th, which we could also write as the decimal 0.01. Finally, we have the rational exponent definition. X to the m over n power equals the nth root of x to the m, but we can also define it as the nth root of x all raised to the m power. Here's an example on the right, 16 to the 3/4. By definition, that's the fourth root of 16 raised to the third power. I'm using the latter definition because it's a lot easier to use that form for this problem. The fourth root of 16 is just 2, because 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 is 16, and we raise that to the third power, and we get 8. The other definition would require us to take the third power of 16, which would be some large number, and then take the fourth root of that, which might not be too obvious. We'd still get 8, but it would be a bit more work. Now let's take a look at some radical properties. Some basic properties. If you have the square root of x squared, that's going to equal x if x is known to be a positive value. So if x were 2, 2 squared would be 4, and the square root would be 2. However, the square root of x squared is the opposite of x if we know that x is a negative value. For example, if x is negative 3, negative 3 squared would be positive 9, and when we take the square root, we'd get 3. Now that's not equal to x, that's equal to the opposite of x. And for an equation, the square root of x squared is plus or minus x, if x is some unknown. Some basic rules for radicals. One is the product rule. The square root of a times b equals the square root of a times the square root of b. That rule also applies for roots other than square roots. It would apply to third roots, fourth roots, and so on. Likewise, we have the quotient rule. The square root of a over b is equal to the square root of a divided by the square root of b, and likewise that rule would apply to other types of roots. We can rationalize the denominator of a fraction like 1 over square root of x by multiplying by another radical on the top and the bottom so that we have no radical in the denominator. That's what rationalizing the denominator means. Here we do this by multiplying by square root of x over square root of x. Now square root of x over square root of x is equal to 1, so we have not changed the value. The result is square root of x over x because the square root of x by itself equals x. If we have a radical that's a binomial, like 1 over a plus square root of b, we would multiply by the conjugate of the denominator, 1 minus square root of b. And likewise, if the denominator were 1 minus square root of b, we would rationalize the denominator by multiplying by a plus the square root of b, the conjugate over itself. We'll look at some examples of this in the next few pages. For now, let's look at the examples on the right. If we have an equation x squared equals 5, that is going to have solutions x equals plus or minus the square root of 5. In the next example, we want to simplify the radical square root of 200. Well, we can do that by rewriting 200 as 100 times 2 and then applying the product rule to rewrite it as the square root of 100 times the square root of 2. The square root of 100 turns into 10. The square root of 2 we leave as is, so our result is 10 square roots of 2. In the next example, we have square root of a fraction, 4/49. By using the quotient rule, we can rewrite that as the square root of 4 over the square root of 49, and that equals 2/7. And in the last example at the bottom, we want to rationalize the denominator of the fraction x over the square root of 2x. We can do so by multiplying x over the square root of 2x by square root of 2x over square root of 2x. And when we do that, the bottom turns into 2x. The top is x times the square root of 2x. And if you notice, the x's cancel out. 1x cancels out with the other x. So then our result is the square root of 2x over 2.